Hi and welcome back to Cessna Home Cockpit. Today I'm going to show you how I'm building my own autopilot and a transponder. The purpose for me is to create something like this. It's X-Plane running on my laptop, and what I did is I searched the internet to find a picture of the transponder I'm going to build and the autopilot, and I printed this out. You can see it over here. This is what I found on the internet. It's a Garmin, I think it's a GTX 327, and then it's a transponder from Garmin and an autopilot. But they are not exactly the same as the ones in the X-Plane, as you can see, but they will do. What I then did is I ordered on AliExpress an Arduino Mego board. It's about $10, and I used ArtSimX to connect the buttons and the switches to the computer. It's connected to a USB port, and the USB cable is going to the Mego board from the Arduino. It's Mego 2560, quite cheap. And as you can see, I already did some wiring, and I printed out the picture, this one, on other paper, and I just cut out the textures from the knobs and glued them on some plastic knobs, which I already printed. And the result is, as you can see, this. It's fully functional. Let me show you when it's live up. And as you can see, there are some LEDs behind it. It's actually very easy. I 3D printed the board, installed some LEDs, some switches, which I glued together with some soldering. Piece of hardboard, not that difficult to make. And as you can see, the buttons work. So I now can use the transponder. What I still have to do is the orange LEDs which you see over here. It's now on standby. This is on, this is off, and this is altitude. So I still have to work that out, how I can operate them. Also, the autopilot is working. As you can see, the light autopilot is lighting up. That's something which doesn't work, because in sim it's not auto on. It's very weird. When I push the button off, the LED goes out, but here the autopilot goes on. So it has to be the other way around. This also goes for the vertical speed. Vertical speed is on, but the LED is off, and when I turn the vertical speed on, the LED goes on. And here it goes off. So those two are not right, but the other ones work. Heading works, as you can see. Heading is on, and heading is on here. And if I turn now the switch on my panel, I can go heading on and off. Same goes for navigation. Navigation, approach, and both switches come on. Just as in the autopilot, and altitude. And obviously when you switch altitude off, then vertical speed goes also off. Because if you want to keep the altitude, vertical speed has to be set to nil. So all buttons work, very easy to build. Only takes some time and some hardboard, 3D printer, and I print everything myself. Now I have to install it in the cockpit and see if that works. And I have to do some work on the LEDs. The lettering is not quite good, but it's just a prototype connected to an Arduino board, USB port to the computer, and just basically just print how it printed this. I can show you is how it works in X-Plain. We have a plugin. This is the RSim plugin. And when I switch over the header button, you can see I'm on 28, 26. So now you can see how it is connected. Very easy, very user friendly. And well, if you have any questions about how to build this, please feel free to contact me and I will try to help. Thanks for watching and see you all soon. Bye bye.